Okay, more Dread Delusion time. I haven't really had too much of a chance to record lately because it's been like 120 degrees in, it's been like 120 degrees where I live. So trying to run my computer is extremely bad. It's not a great feeling. I hope everyone is doing well, though. Let's see. Oh, demonstrator claims she asked you to walk through a mirror hidden inside the house in Lower Ferropolis. Okay, let's do that part, because I know where that is. I also want to talk to some of these people down here in Lower Ferropolis, but I don't know where they all are. I thought there was someone down here. Well, guess it doesn't matter. Fundamentally uncurious, I guess. That's me. That's the mirror. Lockpick. Nice. Now what is in here? Just a squirming godlet? Seems odd. You step out the other side of the mirror. For a moment, you think you're still in Ferropolis until you look up and see the sky is gone. Instead of the Oneric Isle's familiar red Noron star, there is only blackness, save for swirling gyre of dim blue light staring down at you like a malevolent eye. A tenement drifts overhead, unmoored from the earth, tumbling slowly end over end. All around you, the city twists up impossibly into the air, houses piled upon houses, pipes and drains and gutters spreading like tree branches as far as the eye can see. Look around. Look around. Well, cast your return home spell. You summon the mnemonic mandala in your mind's eye and begin the mouth of well-practiced syllables. But all you get is a sudden splitting headache. It feels like your brain is trying to climb a vast featureless black surface without even a crack for handhold. Through thick and thin, you've come to rely on the cipher magic answering your call. To suddenly be without it is utterly terrifying. Look around. It's freezing here. Frost crunches under your feet, and every surface is hung with icicles. You see statues in naturalistic poses cluttering the street, but no people. From somewhere nearby, there's the sound of discordant music. Examine one of the statues. Your stomach twists as you realize the statue was once a living person. Their mouth is open and their fist raised in the air, as if they were frozen solid in the midst of a screaming argument. As you explore, you find another frozen person lying tucked up in a bed in the middle of the street, wearing a nightcap with a pom-pom on the end. Then a family sitting around a dinner table, forks and cups suspended halfway through their mouths. You shiver. Why the hell did Aphra bring you here? Look for the source of the music. This is interesting, but like at the same time, it feels like a real missed opportunity that we can't just explore this place. You know what I mean? Look for the source of the music. The music verges on random noise. Every time you think you've figured out the structure, it changes and slips from your grasp. Sometimes it stops for several minutes, and all you can do is wait, shivering. In the deserted remnants of an old plaza, you find a grand piano, its keys plinking and plonking on their own. No other living soul is visible. You shiver. Why the hell did Aphra bring you here? Ignore the scenery and search for a way out. Time seems to work differently here. You feel like you're wandering for hours, but it could be minutes. At some point, you realize you're now upside down in relation to where you started. A rowing boat with two petrified passengers spins in the air. Finally, leaning on the railings of the catwalk that goes nowhere, clad in a well-worn fur coat, you spot Aphra. She waves at you. Aphra's breath mists in the air as she gives you a wry smile. Well, fancy seeing you here. So this is what you wanted to show me. Yes, this is what the king has been doing. Everything you see here was vanished from our world by the king's magic. When they vanish, reality adjusts around them as if they were never there. There are hundreds of people here. Houses, streets, towns. It's a silent massacre no one's allowed to think about. And it's speeding up. Can't we help these people? Bring them back somehow? Aphra looks pained. Anything that stays here more than about 6.5 hours becomes irrevocably void-touched and would disintegrate upon returning to our world. The best we can do is try to stop the inflow. What do you mean it's speeding up? Do you know what exponential means? Suppose you have 2 spore mites and they breed, then you have 4 spore mites and they breed, then you have 8 spore mites and they breed. Oh shit. Indeed. How can this be stopped? Aphra twists up the corner of her mouth in a mirthless smile. I was hoping you'd say that. We've lingered here long enough. If you're willing to help, step through the mirror and meet me back in Unison Park after nightfall. I have another question first. Let's not chat too long lest we become permanent residents. How is this possible? Years ago, I joined the Machinists. We gave the king the power to alter people by magic. The idea was that a new society would need a new kind of citizen with new virtues and skills. Before long, my colleagues began using this power to rewrite troublesome personalities or even erase them from existence. I wish I'd paid closer attention. It wasn't my department, you understand. But this is beyond anything we've ever asked for. I've scoured the logs and almost everything here was vanished by the king on its own initiative. In other words, we've lost control. Sounds like you got your wish. Aphra winces. Perhaps. I should have asked more questions, raised more objections. But please believe me, most of my colleagues are not evil people. No one wanted this. In fact, I found evidence of at least 12 missing machinists from my own department whom nobody remembers. Did any of them try to raise the alarm? Am I really the first to find this place? No wonder. Oh, that's all I needed to know. Very well, shall we depart? Let's get out of here. Okay. Interesting. I think that this feels a little bit half-implemented. I don't fully know why we couldn't have just teleported through it like every other mirror that we've gone through. Like, it's a little half-baked. You can't make, like, a little level that we have to walk around. You know what I mean? Like, I don't know. A little sus, that's all. Because I feel like the people who made this game are pretty talented. So it feels a little bit off that it just shows you that through text. All right. There are a few other little places I want to go to. I want to go back up to the machinist guy. Because... What's his name? Because I got the thing and I can read now. Also, I have the evidence that, like, he might be the reason why everything's all fucked up. So, I think it is just right over here, right? Yeah. Okay. So maybe I went down instead of up. Wait a minute, what? Three patrons huddle around the table, nursing hot mugs and discussing a news sheet with hushed voices. Of course there's nothing about the summoning outage. The machinists would never admit that the saboteur bloodied their noses like that. They notice you listening. Oh, King's favor, pal. Just a few old farts enjoying our weekly ration. Every day I thank my stars I live here and nowhere else. The other patrons are giving this woman a wide berth as if she carries a contagious disease. What are you staring at? Waiting to see if I grow an extra head? I'd pay to see that. She scowls and doubles over and coughs heavily. Keep your money, Ponce. The kingdom pays me well. Not well enough to see what I've seen, though. I'm intrigued. Tell me about yourself. She coughs again and drinks deeply from her mug. Name's Doyle. I'm a royal cleanup worker, you know, fighting the corruption. Hero of the kingdom, they call me. More medals than you've had hot dinners. And what's my reward? Children hide or stare at me wherever I go. Shopkeepers wipe down every service I touch. When I'm done here, the landlady will bury my mug so that I don't contaminate any other patriots. She glares up at you. So what, your friends dare you to talk to me? Come to stammer some shite about how grateful you are for my service, or are you just tired of being human? I'm not afraid, I was just curious. She laughs again. Not afraid of the corruption, huh? Well, take my advice, you should be. 2 more weeks of leave, then I'm back to the corrupted land. Damn the king, but it's never enough. Is that all? No offense, but I might be dead soon and I don't want to spend my last hours with you. I'd like to ask some questions. Doyle snorts. Doyle snorts. Oops, I said that funny. Doyle snorts. And I'd like a ride out of here on a magic carpet. So what? Did you really curse the king earlier? She gives you a hollow smile. Let them execute me. From where I sit, that looks like a promotion. You'd be surprised what I can get away with, newbie. Not many folk can do my job. Is that a threat? She shrugs, taking a sip of her tea. Just an observation. Now scram, will you, or also start wishing I was back in the corrupted lands. How worried should I really be sitting with you? She eyes you appraisingly. We have procedures. 1 week's quarantine before re-entering Ferropolis. 3 rounds of purifying rituals. All our clothes are incinerated each month. This is corruption we're talking about. It never stays still. So I guess it depends on how much you trust in the wisdom of the Machinists Guild. Now scram. Yeah, okay. I'll leave you alone. Alright, so I already got everything from her, basically. So I'm not really that concerned. Because she'd probably just tell us how to get to the corrupted land, and I don't really need to worry about that. I really don't remember where to go. Where is the machinist's headquarters? Is it here? Yes, it is. Speak quickly, citizen. My time is on high demand. I have questions about the kingdom. Yep. I already have all that. I'm an interpreter. We study the king commands. Do you need something? I have quite a lot of reading to get through. I actually had an audience with the king myself. Perform sacramental duty. That's new. Maybe it's a legacy component. Oh, we've already read all this. Okay. Oh, oops. Almost jumped out. Wait a second. Where is the king's area? I thought I could speak to the king. We already did all this. Am I not able to just have a meeting with the king again? I already read this, I think. Ah, there we go. All right, let's read what the king said to us before. So we can't accuse Sunil yet. Just interesting. Subject, thine audience is concluded, thou art dismissed, vacate immediately. Am I not allowed to read the transcript now that I have eyeballs? Huh. I guess not. Okay. Well, it's kind of a dead end. I was really hoping we could come back and investigate after doing all that work, but I guess we just can't. I guess there's just nothing to learn from there. Our sovereign is not pleased with us, friend. The signs are everywhere if you know where to look. Only by redoubling our efforts and rooting out the disloyal among us may we win back the Majesty's trust. Long live the king. Long live the king. Yeah, I don't know. They eye you up and down suspiciously. Ain't seen you around here before, not a resin, I'll warrant. Actually, I just moved in. They appraise you cautiously. Right, welcome to the icebox, then. My condolences. Name's Cower. I saw a car. I solve problems around here, and I look after folk. Guess that includes you. Let's see. Boilers are busted right now. Maeve in number 4 has got extra blankets if you need them. You get a hold of anything to burn, you share it around, and we'll do the same for you. Folks here look after each other. Last thing, we don't want any problems in this building. Things are hard enough without the king's wrath coming down on us. You get involved with anything funny, you keep it to yourself. These are good people, do you understand? They don't deserve no trouble. Don't make me none, and we'll get on just fine. How's everyone doing here? Can't complain, but I'm worried about Yosip in number 28. Cold's bad enough in the main building, let alone in the floaters. You come across any spare fuel, you let me know. Hey, don't you notice something weird about this building? Weird like what? Like newcomers asking funny questions? The room numbers go up to 28, but there's only 5 rooms. They pause to digest this. It's clear they haven't thought about it before. Huh. Now that you mention it, that is weird. They shrug. Probably just another little royal whoopsie, assigning room numbers that don't make no sense. Typical. Oh, so many of them disappeared. Any advice for a new neighbor? Let's see. Boilers are busted right now. Maven number... blah, blah, blah. Still have that. Who put you in charge here? I don't see machinist brooch. Car snorts. Just an ordinary resident like everyone else. A little thing called being a good neighbor. You might try it sometime. King's favor to you. Is there anything, like, gameplay-wise to, like, fix here, I guess? Resident's accent resins are well-healed compared to their neighbors. Perhaps you've already met the redoubtable citizen Carr. They get a little fierce sometimes, but don't take it personally. They're just trying to do the right thing. It's an awful shame about poor Nadia. My heart breaks for her mother. I hope she gets through it. We're all rooting for her. What's wrong with Nadia? Oh, I'm sorry. Are you a friend? Nadia's very sick. Can't get out of bed. If you dropped by to wish her well, I'm sure her mother would appreciate it. Hmm. When Uncle Yosip's room split off the building, we got no warning, none whatsoever. Now I have to winch my supplies up to him in a bucket. You wouldn't believe the bribes you have to pay for a ladder around here. Mind, the lady in number 12 snores like a sky barge engine. I should know I fix them. Is that poop? Or a laundry basket? I can't tell. The boiler's a death trap, but they let my son, will they let my son look at it? No, that'd be tampering with royal property in 3 days in the stocks. Only a bona fide machinist with a work order from the king is authorized to fix it. But how do you get one of those? That's right, another bloody petition. They'll all be frozen solid by the time they get to us. This young woman lies tucked up in bed with a toddlike and unselfconscious peace that blesses all sound sleepers. Her face is creaked in an expression of unease as if grappling with some private impasse. Someone has brushed her hair back neatly over her head so it doesn't get in her eyes. This middle-aged woman looks worn down to the bone, with bags under her eyes and deep worry lines in her forehead. Her jet-black hair is unkempt but held in place by a long ornamented pin of surprising finery. Hello, are you one of Nadia's pals? I'm afraid she's not seeing anyone right now. Is she all right? Looks like she's out for the count. Something about your manner seems to cut her, and when she speaks, her voice cracks as if she's about to cry. No, she's not all right. The woman closes her eyes and takes in a deep breath. I apologize, stranger. You're not seeing me at my best just now. I'm Nadia's mother, Yasmin. This last month, I've been her full-time carer as well. It's those bottled visions, you see. What happened to her? Our family has had a rough few years. And there wasn't much joy in her life, so when Nadia first started getting into visions, I was happy for her. Then she began spending all her free time dreaming. Soon she was sleeping until noon and missing work. Now she barely wakes up at all, and she's never lucid when she does. She can't work, can't even feed herself, but she does need food and fuel to keep warm. With all these summoning glitches, I have to pay cash on the black market, and we're down to the last dregs of our savings. Yasmin shrugs despairingly. Just don't know how we can survive like this for much longer. Isn't there some kind of treatment? Yasmin throws up her hands in frustration. I don't know, I'm not an alchemist or any kind of vision expert. We petitioned the king for a doctor to visit, but the way things are, it'll be months before we hear back. Maybe I could find Nadia a doctor. A tentative hope is kindled in her eyes. Oh, would you? Yes, you could ask Vidal the vision trader about it. I doubt I could face him myself without knocking his lights out and trashing his shop. Vidal must have seen cases like Nadia's before. Is there any way to help her? He'd surely know. She arches her eyebrows. If he refuses, you tell him he'll answer to me. Yasmin makes her best attempt at a smile. Was there anything else? How are you doing, Yasmin? I mean you, not Nadia. She thinks for a long time before responding. When she does, her words are eerily calm. Sometimes I just want to scream. Scream and scream and scream and scream. And keep screaming until I ruin my throat and can't make any noise at all. Do you know something? I don't think anything would happen. Nobody would respond. We're also trained to stay in our little circles of candlelight, to never really think about what's happening around us. Because if you think about it, then it becomes real for you, too. And not just for some other poor bastard you don't know. Maybe I'd be the same if not for what's happened to Nadia. Yasmin makes her best attempt at a smile. Alright. I'll go to Vidal's vision shop. Why not, right? Now, where's Grampy's house? Is it here? Is that it? Oh, fuck. Hold on, let's go back up and try to get up there. I don't know if it's possible, but it would be cool if there is just one random doorway that we can manage to, like, climb up to. Okay, I don't want to fall off. That would be bad, right? I'm guessing. I don't really see any other places, so. Or any other doors. Yeah, it doesn't look like it. So, okay. Let's see. Is there... Nope, not on that side. Is there an open window on the other side, though? Let's look. Nope. Okay, so we can't go up there. That's fine. Let's go to Vidal's vision shop. I think I know where that is. Thought it was... Is it over here? No. I don't remember. It's around somewhere. I think this is the clothier. What the? Why is this locked right now? Oh my god, give me a good roll. There we go. Oh, this is how you get behind. Glorious silk? Okay, that's useless. Not helpful at all. I guess I can try to go into the armorer's shop next. Is that a thing? Is it just like nighttime? Yeah, that must be it. Perfect. Okay, interesting. Glorious treasure. Sick. Okay. Cool. Where is the Vision Trader shop? I don't remember. I guess I could have asked what's her name about it, but... I don't know. Is it right here? Yes. Perfect. Bittersweet Bottled Vision, a perfect copy of a single vivid dream. These lurid fantasies, this one is by Anonymous, contains scenes of tenderness and devastating heartbreak. Cool. Okay, so it's right here. I just need to sleep until morning to actually be able to go in and talk to him, I guess. Okay. And then we go over here and we rest. I guess I could have done like the other mission or whatever in order to, could have done the other mission, and like find the, oh, it's really bright. I totally forgot that the game got bright during the day. I could have gone to the square at night or whatever to meet up with Aphra, but it's fine. I'll just rest again after. 10 gold is nothing. I'm here on behalf of a customer called Nadia. Nadia? Why, yes, she's a regular of mine. One of my best customers, actually, but I haven't seen her in weeks. Is anything the matter? It's not good, I'm afraid. She's very sick. Vidal's face falls into an expression of horror as you explain the situation. Oh. Oh, dear. Oh, dear, oh, dear. I've read about this happening, of course. I've just never, I mean, nobody I know. Look, I don't know anything about this. I'm just a shopkeeper, you understand? Am I meant to believe you didn't notice your best customer was an addict? Vidal looks sick to his stomach. What? No, I mean, it's not my place to tell people what they can and can't do, is it? King knows I never wanted to do her any harm. Dr. Prip, that's the man you want. He's a medicinal genius, or he's a medical genius, and quite a canny businessman. He invented much of the technology that sustains our trade. I know he's been studying dream sickness very closely. Prip runs the Royal Vision Works out in Cloudpine Oblast. It's in the far northeast of the kingdom, on its own little island out beyond the mountains. I'm sure he'll have some treatment or elixir for poor Nadia. Vidal sighs, sounding rather less chirpy than usual. What else can I do for you? See what you're selling. He doesn't sell anything. Okay. Okay, neat. Let's go to Cloud Pine of Blast, I guess. Why not, right? I need to remember to pick up more supplies. What's down here? Ever tried to petition for a home in the Upper City? Pointless. King rejected me because my comedy score was too low. What does that even mean? I swear they just make up a number and pretend there's some wizardry behind it. Then if you ask how to increase it, they say it's too complicated to explain. Alright, so we should probably leave this place. You see an old beggar wrapped up in rags against the cold. Pal, excuse me, pal, do you know where my house is? Sorry, did you just ask me where your house is? The beggar looks confused, like they didn't expect you to actually stop. Yeah, I did. I'm so sorry to bother a fine citizen such as yourself. I just can't seem to find it anywhere. Do you know where your own house is? They look abashed. King's truth, pal, I have no clue. I know I had one somewhere in the Upper City, I just can't seem to recall any of the details. How do you know you had one, then? The beggar delves into the rags around their neck and produces an ornate key on a string, holding up in their blackened fingernails like a talisman. Because I've got this. Where'd you get that key from? It's mine, I swear by the king. I've always had it in my pocket, and I remember, remember my first night on the streets. It was like a nightmare. I knew I'd had a house only the night before. I didn't know shite about sleeping rough. I kept thinking, tomorrow I'll surely find it. Tomorrow this will be over. That was 2 years ago. Beggar clings to the key like a childhood doll. Gotta be around here somewhere. I must go, but I can give you some coin. Or could you try it on some doors? I tried plenty. Turns out nobody likes doing that without asking first. And if you do ask first, then nobody lets you. All the thought, I was just mad. Now the militia know my face, so it's tough for me to leave the conduits. Because it's warmer down here where the steam pipes are. The beggar clings to the key like a childhood doll. Gotta be around here somewhere. I must go, but I can give you some coin. Oh no, don't bother yourself. All I need is to find my house. I'll be grand. Get me old jaw back. Get on my feet. Give 20 coins. But wait, their eyes well up, torn between shame and gratitude. Thank you, pal. I promise when I find my house, I'll repay you double, triple. I'll even give you a bed whenever you need it. Pour ye a dram any time. Nice. That's going to be helpful for us if we ever, like, solve the king problem and restore everything. We'll have a safe house here. Presumably, right? That's what that means. That's what I assume it means. Weapon, weapon, fuck are ya? Glyke it, we scroat. Oi, weapon. Looking to buy a weapon, are you? They squint at you, unsure of your intentions. Weapon? Weapon's my pet. So called because he's a pure spanner. Come here, you wee dauber. What? Okay. Whatever. All right, we gotta go up. I gotta go up to get out. Where are we headed? Over here. Okay, so we need to find Cloud Pine of Blast, which is in the northeast beyond the mountains. So I guess we just go do that. Ooh. Oh boy, it is very warm in my room. Where is Cloud Pine of Blast? I see. Okay. It is like right here. It's probably there. Probably at the top of that mountain. I don't know. It said it was on a island beyond the mountains, maybe. Oh, is it over there? I don't know. Let's check over here first, though. Because I don't know what's over here. This looks like it could be hiding secrets. Paradoxicus, we needed that. Did I already go over there? There we go. Oh my god, we're burning through my lockpicks. It's probably a good thing though. Fine ore, yay. Because we've been maxed out on them for so long. Is this Cloud Pine of Blast? Oh, so awesome. So much ore. Let's go. Death's Veil. We've got a bunch of those, but we haven't really done anything with them yet. All right, is this a place? This looks like it could be the place. I like this game a lot. Very easy to play. All right, cartography landmark. The clerk trills in a sing-song voice that's clearly practiced hundreds of times. Hello, citizen, welcome to Royal Vision Works. Are you here for yourself or on behalf of someone else? Someone else. Lovely, now I must inform you that we can't sign a contract without meeting the candidate in person or examining them if they're medically incapable, but I'm happy to walk you through the details. We have a number of positions open with contracts ranging from 3 clockwork standard months to 12 years. How long were you thinking of staying? Sorry, never mind all that. I need to talk to Dr. Prip. Sorry, Dr. Pripp is extremely busy at the present and is only seeing visitors by appointment. Can I help you with anything else? Ma'am, I'm afraid there's been a complaint. I need to see Pripp personally. A complaint? From whom? Sorry, who are you exactly? I'm with the DRB, ma'am. Now, I'm not at liberty to name the complainant, but we have a duty to take this seriously. The clerk interrupts you with practiced aplomb. Let me stop you there, Inspector. We have a process for this. I'll need a signed and stamped complaint form, otherwise I can't help you. Never mind. That's fine. I will literally sneak in. I am not scared. Sealed by an unseen device. We can work with that. We can absolutely work with that. Hello. Nice. Hey, the vision trade. Yasmin's daughter Nadia has fallen into an endless sleep due to a bottled vision addiction, leaving her family on the brink of ruin. You've managed to find a way inside the Royal Vision Works, where you've been told you might find a cure for Nadia. Now to look for Dr. Pripp. Sweet. Iron ore. Oh, okay, that's useful. Lockpicks. Love that. Ooh, and cash. Slumbering citizen is clawing at the air with an expression of wonder on their face. Sorry, mate. No time to chat. I have a lot of bedpans to empty and clean before the end of my shift, and the vegetables aren't about to lend a hand. This technician is watching over one of the sleepers with a pensive expression on their face. You know, sometimes I wonder what they're going through. It must be amazing in its own way. From the outside, it looks like they're snoozing as soundly as a baby, given gin to keep it quiet, but inside, they're living lives we can barely imagine, full of wonder and terror. Have you ever tried one of their visions? Me? Oh no, I never touch the stuff. My friends think I'm weird, but maybe they'd feel the same after working here. Brutal. That's kind of crazy. Mm-hmm. Okay, so this is actually just like a cut and paste of a different building. They all have like a, they're probably governmental structures or something of some kind. We're looking around for interactables first, just to make sure we don't miss none. Good, we didn't. Okay. Smell of jasmine lingers around the successfully well-kept man. Little round spectacles frame his cadaverous face, and a neatly trimmed mustache nestles on his top lip. Oh, well, there's something one doesn't see every day. A mystery visitor. I know all the names and faces of my workers, regular visitors, so I would warrant you are here to see me. He gives you a small but theatrical bow. Dr. Carl von Pripp, at your service. Physician, vision right, and appointed steward of all the industrious dreamers who serve here. So what brings you to the Royal Vision Works today? I'm here on behalf of a woman who can't wake up. Dr. Pripp listens to your tale with studious dispassion, his brows slightly furrowed. It is a most unfortunate case, alas, it's also a familiar one. Would you like the good news first or the bad news? Don't play games with me. Can you help or not? Pripp sighs. Chalk up another failure for my bedside manner, I suppose. I never could get the hang of that. There is no known cure for chronic onirism once it advances to such a late stage. Nevertheless, there may still be a way that I can help. The simplest option is for Nadia to join our happy crew. Many of our workers are chronic cases like her, and I can assure you they're comfortable and well taken care of. Her mother would share in the profits while being relieved of the burden of caring for her, and could visit regularly during our open hours. Naturally, we would also pay you a finder's fee. Alternatively, Yasmin could buy her own vision siphon, also known as a dream crown. I believe the current price is 120 coins, including permit fees. This would enable her to support Nadia at home by bottling and selling her visions independently. You can't be serious. Look around you. Does it seem to you as if I'm joking? Nadia and Yasmin are not the first to suffer this predicament, and I am afraid they will not be the last. Let me get this straight. Bottled visions make people sick, and then you use those people to make more bottled visions. I must correct you on one point. Only a very small percentage of vision imbibers suffer from chronic onirism, and invariably we find that they have a history of excessive use. The label does warn you against that, you know. Okay, tell me more about Yasmin buying a dream crown. Memory serves, she could buy one at Vidal's shop. She would need a permit, but since I chair the body that approves said permits, that won't be a problem. I must caution you that without the benefit of our extensive distribution network and our royal monopoly on exports, this option would inevitably be less lucrative for Yasmin. On the other hand, with practice, Yasmin could learn to capture her own dreams and administer them to Nadia, potentially permitting a form of bidirectional communication between the pair. Tell me about Nadia becoming one of your workers. Chronic Onearists are an interesting cohort. For all their outward lethargy, their imaginations remain superbly active, which is to say profitable. Here at the works, we can bottle their visions en masse using cutting-edge equipment, and we enjoy good relationships and very favorable rates with both domestic and foreign distributors. We also host a weekly support group for our family members of Chronic Onearists, which Yasmin would be welcome to attend. Any other questions? Very well, I'll have to see what Yasmin thinks. Why don't you take one of our standard contracts for her to read through? Pre-stamped 0th class Royal Post envelope is included in the package. If Yasmin accepts her offer, I shall leave your finder's fee with Vidal, the vision trader in Ferropolis. Thanks, I suppose. Remember, this is not a decision that should be taken lightly. I encourage Yasmin to take all the time she wishes. That's, fucked up. That's really messed up. I don't know what the right option is there. You know, I do think it's in this game's character. I really hope there isn't a way to wake her up, right? Like, we just have to pick whatever one we think is better. Or at least let her pick, like give her the dignity of picking. I think giving her a dream crown because it comes at a cost to us is probably the most noble option. If only because it's like, I don't know, like actively might allow communication. Like that seems pretty significant to me. It's honestly, it's like sad, but like could, it's like a almost like a transhumanist perspective of like maybe she has entered like a new state of being. I don't know. You find Yasmin feeding her daughter porridge from a wooden bowl, singing a soft lullaby. She looks worn down to the bone. Yasmin glances in your direction. Hello again. Do you have any luck? I managed to find a doctor, but it's not good news. You hand her the sheaf of papers that Prip gave you and begin to explain. From the way Yasmin listens, you can tell that she has plenty of experience maintaining composure in the face of tragedy. This time, though, it's not enough. Give her a silent hug. When she's finished, she looks over at Nadia for a long time. Oh, my darling, how could I have let this happen to you? Yasmin looks back at you. I know you did your best, but this is quite the dilemma you've brought me. What do you think I should do? I'd keep Nadia at home even if it'll be a struggle sometimes. Yes, you can't put a price on family. I may not know how to care for Nadia properly or bottle visions, but I can learn. King knows I've seen a lot of change in my life. Although it would be a lot of work. If my sickness flares up, I might not be able to keep the business going, which could easily end up back where we started without a penny. My heart tells me I should keep Nadia here, no matter how long it takes for me to learn the vision trade or how difficult it would be to take care of her. If there's any way I can still communicate with her, even if it's only through dreams, I want to take it. Truthfully, though, it's moot. I don't have 120 coins to buy a dream crown from Vidal, and I doubt I ever will. My neighbors have been tremendous help, but there isn't that much cash in this entire tenement. I suppose I'll get in touch with this Dr. Prip and begin the process. What else can I do? What if I could pay for a dream crown? You can tell that Yasmin is conflicted about your offer. What? Oh, no, no, no. I couldn't possibly accept that. You've already helped so much. I insist. Call it a loan if you'd like. No interest. Pay it back before the world ends. She smiles a little and then looks up at you with tears in her eyes. Very well, then. That will be enough time, I should think. Whatever the outcome, you've helped Nadia more than I could have asked. I wish I could pay for your time, but well, perhaps this will suffice. This is the deed to our old family home just outside Ferropolis. Technically, we need to petition the Clockwork King for a change of ownership, but since the militia have all but abandoned the countryside, you should be left alone. Yasmin, I can't accept this from you. Oh, yes, you can. What use would we have for it anyway? Restoring that place a full-time job, one for someone without a lungful of spores. Yasmin arches her eyebrows mischievously. Call it a loan if you like, no interest, just give it back before the world ends. Where is this house exactly? It's not far from here, off to the north. If you leave via main checkpoint, you should keep going forward. You should find it on a cliff overlooking the forest. Thank you, Yasmin. This time her smile is warm and genuine. May you have more luck with it than we did. Okay, so I got a house. That's sick. Interesting. I thought I was going to have to, I was having to purchase it. So that's neat. We helped someone and we got a house. So that's actually, that kind of like works out in our favor, mathematically speaking. That's really not bad at all. Wow, they had a really nice house. All right. My home. And I'm still missing so many pieces. Clockwork Kingdom. 15 coins. All right, so I just need coins and Eye of Pygoth for the house. I just need coins for this. I don't need the workshop, really. You lack the necessary upgrade material, so I need Eye of Pygoth. I wonder if there's an easy way for me to get that. Is there an alchemy store here? I don't know. I don't think there is, but we can check. Because if I can get alchemy materials, then actually we might be like golden. Maybe they're down here. Trader looks nervous, keeps one protective hand on their stall. King's blessing, citizen. Don't often see new faces down here. Have we met before? I've not so much in stock just now, but if you have wee mouse to feed, maybe I can set something aside next time I do. What can you tell me about this place? You mean the conduits? It's not posh and it's far from pretty, but it's warm and it's cheap and the militia don't bother us, so I suppose that makes it home. This wee bit here is what we call the bazaar. There's no summoning stations down here, and it's harder to invoke the king's magic. Some folks see that as a blessing, though. To the cogs, it seems to be out of sight, out of mind. Why do you keep spelling out words? A lot of folk think you can escape the king's notice by avoiding certain words, like B-U-Y or C-O-S-T. No idea if it works, but it can't hurt, so I don't S-E-L-L anything. I unpossess it. Don't get it twisted, mind. The machine is staying against commerce or making money. You've seen all those fancy shops up top, aye? They just hate anything you can't track and measure. That's how they stay in control. Anyhow, it is what it is. How come you're down here, not up there? I used to have an S-H-O-P in the upper city until my license got revoked with no explanation. Meant to have a broken law, but its majesty didn't see fit to tell me which one. I petitioned 17 times for a new license. Every single petition got it rejected. For reasons never made any sense, eventually I gave up. So what, you're doing illegal? No one really knows. Some SALES are technically allowed as long as you follow certain rules, but they won't tell you the rules in any way. It's always changing. Other stuff is technically banned, except for special cases. Only seems to, like, everything is special case because no one ever gets punished. When the machinists do arrest someone, they don't explain why. We just have to guess what they did wrong and try not to do the same thing. It is what it is. King's blessing to you. Conduits are beautiful in the rain, you know, all the water running down from the upper city, rivers, curtains, down pipes, gutters, cascading off all the bits of machinery. Maybe you'll get to see it too if spring ever returns. Are you a person? What's this now, my dear? Let me find my looking glass. Why is your face so small? She fishes among the charms dangling at her neck and produces a large glass lens, which has the disconcerting effect of magnifying her eye to enormous size. Much better, yes. You see, my dear, I must read your lips, for my ears cannot hear your words. Her one giant pupil dances back and forth like a fish in a bowl as she examines you. You seek alchemical aid, do you not? Eye of worm and hair of slug and all that? I am Madame Lascaux, and in the roiling mist of your future, I sense a most fruitful relationship for both of us. My dear, alas, my dear, if only I could bottle a happier fate for you. Still, perhaps there's something I can do. See what you're selling. Truth potion. God damn it, she doesn't sell. She doesn't sell ingredients. God damn it. I thought she would. Shoot.